Good morning. My name is Shiva Analalakirajan and my matrix number is B09201-0467. Today I'm here with my friends to explain about our thermodynamics assignment, which is steam cycles basics and the reheat cycle improved. Our lecturer name is Dr. Ahmad Fuad bin Abdul Rashid and we are from 2BMME section 2/1. My group members are Wan Zul Hamilzan bin Wan Zul Kifli, Muhammad Daniel Haikal bin Muhammad Rizali, Afif Nafal bin Muhammad Burhan, Muhammad Haikal bin Abdul Wahab and Muhammad Izzati bin Samusi. I will explain the first part, which will be the introduction, history and application. Steam cycle is a fundamental system in which steam is produced in a boiler and expands via a turbine to extract bulk, then condenses the steam into water and returns the water back to the boiler. The founder of the steam cycle can be also known as a Rankine cycle, and the founder of this Rankine cycle is William John McCann Rankine, a Scottish polymath professor at Glasgow University. He is the founder of the steam cycle we know now. On the bottom left, we can see a photo of the founder with William John McCann Rankine. Okay, now we look into the applications of steam cycle. It is used in chemical and pharmaceutical sectors, as this sector requires high power electricity and heat to do many processes to complete their products. Then we can also see the application in trash treatment plants. In there also, the steam turbine, which uses the steam cycle, are used to generate electricity to extract energy from the waste. In oil and gas sectors, the steam turbine, which uses the steam cycle, acts as a pump drive or compressor to extract the oil and gas. From the application, we can classify the application of steam cycle in two main categories. The main uses are, it is an alternate way to generate electricity, to generate heat source, and helps the machine in mechanical operation, such as the bulk generated from it is then used as a pump to ensure the flow and compressor to compress the materials. On the bottom right, we can see a process where how electricity is generated from the steam cycle. Okay, next we'll look into the reheat cycle. The reheat cycle is an improved version of the steam cycle. The aim of this improvement in steam cycle is the moisture in the steam, which will be transferred to the final phases of expansion, to be eliminated completely. The reheat was introduced in 1920s, but it was discontinued back then due to technological challenges. Then when the production of high pressure boilers became high during the 1940s, the reheat cycle was once again developed, and in 1950s, double reheating was introduced. The application of this reheat cycle can be seen in the present power plant that runs at supercritical pressure, where double reheating is a typical practice. The applications are same as the steam cycle basics, to generate electricity, heat source, and help the machine to do mechanical work. But in this improved cycle, there will be a better efficiency of work done compared to its predecessor cycle, which is steam cycle basics. Okay, that's all from me. Thank you.
Okay, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Afif Nafa bin Muhammad Burhan, and my matrix number is B0920-1. Now, I want to explain about component of steam cycle basic and the reheat cycle improved. Okay, for steam cycle, this is steam cycle. First, for function of pump, the pump delivers liquid water to the boiler. Next, boiler. The boiler heats water to superheated steam. Next, for turbine, is device that produce work at the expense of temperature and pressure. Last, for condenser in steam cycle, is device for reducing a gas or vapor to a liquid. And next, for reheat cycle. Okay, for function of pump, the pump delivers liquid water to the boiler. That boiler, the boiler heated water to superheated steam. But for reheat cycle, has two turbine. For the first turbine, from boiler, liquid enter the first turbine, which is high pressure turbine. Before entering the condenser, it enter the low pressure turbine to completely eliminate moisture in the steam. Function for turbine is device that produce work at the expense of temperature and pressure. Last, for condenser, device for reducing a gas or vapor to a liquid. Okay, that's all from me. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum and very good morning. My name is Muhammad Zaki Bisamusi. My matrix number is B09201-0292. So today I want to talk about working principle of basic and improved cycle. Firstly, we look for the steam cycle as a basic. There are many states for this cycle. Firstly, state 6-1, conversion of the liquid in the pump. Based on the TS diagram, if the fluid is not compressible, And if the pump is exotropic, there is no increase in entropy and the temperature remains constant. Secondly, step 1 to 2, liquid preheating. In the ideal cycle, this deformation is isobaric. Temperature and entropy are increased. Next, step 2 to 3, vaporization. The liquid has received its saturation temperature and start boiling. The temperature is constant. The entropy increase. Next, we go to the step 3 to 4, superheating. The vapor is superheated in the boiler. The temperature and the entropy increase. Next, we go for the step 4 to 5, expansion. In the ideal cycle, the expansion is isentropic. In the real cycle, inversibility are generated and increase the entropy. And lastly, step 5 to 6, condensation. At the end of expansion, the vapor start condensing until there is only liquid remain. The temperature is constant, the entropy decrease. Next, we go for the reheat cycle as improved. To get rid of the minimum vapor quality issue at a high pressure, a good solution consists in splitting the expansion in two and introducing a reheating between both turbine states. Firstly, from state 4 to 4A, the high pressure, high temperature vapor is first expanded in the high pressure HP turbine. Secondly, from state 4A to 4B, the high pressure vapor is then returned to the boiler where it is reheated. And lastly, from state 4B to 5, the high temperature minimum pressure vapor is finally expanded in the low pressure LP turbine. That's all for me and thank you.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Muhammad Inaikal bin Muhammad Azali. My metric number is B09201084. So I will explain about the TS diagram for the Rankine cycle, or as known as basic steam cycle. So from the first point, which is from point 1 to point 2, it is called as isentropic compression, which then occur in the system and the pressure of the fluid is increased. Next, point 2 to point 3, which also called as constant pressure and heat addition process. The temperature of highly pressure fluid is increased till it reach boiling point and the fluid will change phase into vapor. Next, point 3 to point 4, we call it as isentropic expansion process. The dry saturated vapor will be expanded and generate energy. And lastly, point 4 to point 1, constant pressure heat rejection. The low temperature and pressure vapor will be condensed and converted into saturated liquid. That's all from me. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Muhammad Haikal bin Abdul Wahab. I will present about cycle diagram of reheat cycle. This is the diagram of reheat cycle. Process 1, the liquid in the pump will be compressed. Process 2, the compressed liquid heated in the boiler until it reaches the boiling point. Then the vapor is superheated in boiler. Process 3, the high pressure and high temperature vapor is expanded in the high pressure turbine. Process 4, the medium pressure vapor then return to the boiler where it is reheated. Process 5, the high temperature and medium pressure vapor is expanded in the low pressure turbine. Process 6, the liquid vapor will undergo condensation in the condenser. TS diagram for reheat cycle. At point 3 is high pressure turbine. At point 4 to 5 is reheating. And at point 5 to 6 is low pressure turbine. And that's all from me. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum. My name is Wazir Hamizan bin Wazir Kifli. My metric number is B09201046. I will present about the disadvantage of basic, which is steam cycle. First of all, since the machine is harsh and heavy, it has low efficiency with high cost. After that, since it uses one turbine, there will be moisture even though it enters the turbine. After that, the turbines which use the steam cycle, which is basic, are less efficient than reciprocating engine. Advantages of improved heat cycle. First of all, it increases thermal efficiency and reduces the water pump power because it has smaller condenser and boiler. After that, it increases the work done per kilogram of steam and this results in reduced size of boiler. Then, it increases the dryness fraction of steam at half so that rate erosion due to impact of water particles is reduced. Suggestions to increase the efficiency of the steam cycle, basic and improved. First of all, we should increase the average temperature at which heat is transferred to the working fluid. After that, decreasing the average temperature of the working fluid at which heat is rejected by the cycle. After that, we should also decrease the condenser pressure enclosed by the cycle on TS diagram to increase the efficiency. Then, superheating the steam to extremely high temperature. After that, increasing the boiler temperature. So, that's all for me. Thank you.